Hi everyone, today we're going to be looking at IEP meetings and kind of thinking about what is discussed, what's the overall purpose of it, and what are the decisions that come from these important meetings. So again, the IEP is developed during the meeting or beforehand, but it should be considered a draft, if you will. So some schools create that draft in advance and then share it in the meeting. Other ones really work it out together in unison in a synchronous time frame. So the ones that are created ahead of time, you definitely want to be able to send that out to various stakeholders to review so they can come in ready to think about it, to talk about it, etc. Remember, it's a working draft. And so as a result of that, parents, student advocates, etc., have the right to make some suggestions for a change as part of this IEP meeting. And so every IEP meeting should really cover several tenets or aspects. Number one, it should present the level of performance, current performance that the student is sort of at across various domains. So the team leader will sort of write a statement about the student's overall current academic levels. It could also be functional performance, such as social or behavioral motor skills for many times, and also goals to be able to move those forward. So it's one thing to say, this is where we are. It's another thing to say, here's where we are, and here's where we're aiming with specific dates in mind. In the next 3 weeks, in the next 6 weeks, this is what we hope to be able to accomplish. And you're going to use data, test scores, observations, all those sorts of things to be able to evaluate to determine whether or not those gains were made accordingly. Second, every IEP should have annual goals that the team reviews, that the team talks about to be able to measure the progress, like we mentioned, that students make towards those goals. And then together you can revise or reconsider some of those goals as you progress through or for the subsequent year ahead. So it's important to look at those goals not only for this current year, but also what were the goals last year and the year before that, to be able to see maybe what has worked best, where have we made gains, and where do we still have room for improvement. Third is around individualized supports and services. So your IEP team should be able to discuss and articulate what are the child's accommodations, what are the modifications to instruction, and what kinds of specialized instruction are really being put in place to support the overall learning outcomes. And then the overall team can update those supports as you move forward, as you track it with data and other evidence along the way. And so one must remember that this is not a one-size-fits-all approach, that every IEP should be very individualized in structure. And to be able to measure this and communicate this to all parties is particularly important. And so how do you wrap up these meetings, knowing that sometimes they are very sensitive in nature and all stakeholders may have differing perspectives? So the team leader will want to make note of any changes to the design, to the overall IEP that was considered a draft. Parents have the right to be able to take these home to review with their legal representation, with family members, with whomever, before they sign and agree to it. So that's something to keep in mind. And when the meeting is over, you don't want to just file that once you get it signed in the closet, in the filing cabinet, in the Dropbox folder, if you will. You want to be able to use that and keep it in an accessible place, so that IEP will really guide the student's day-to-day education for the entire year. And so you have to be able to get ready to continuously monitor how that is playing out, if you will. And so two key takeaways that I want you to remember from this discussion on IEP team meetings. Number one is that the IEP team should really consider questions, insights, and observations to be able to inform what that IEP ends up being. And then secondly, that if a team member cannot attend in person, the right should be made availed for the person to attend via Zoom sometimes in certain school districts, or to be able to postpone that meeting to ensure that all parties and stakeholders have an opportunity to voice their input for this important construction and finalization of the IEP, to be able to ensure that every student has optimal opportunities for success. I hope that was informative, and please feel free to reach out anytime with questions along the way.